Welcome to the subject technical textile. The topic we are going to discuss today is the agro textile. So as last class we have seen the classification of technical textile. This is the first category where we are going to concentrate now, and here we are going to see the detail of the agro textile. So in this coming class, the topics, the content we are going to discuss are we are going to see first of all the introduction of the agro textile, and in that introduction I will see what is the agro textile and what is the need of agro textile. Then after we'll see the technical aspects. Technical aspect means we'll see what is the functions of the agro textile and what is the properties we are expecting from the agro textile, and what types of material, what type of fiber we are going to use in the construction of agro textile. Then afterward we'll see some of the examples, we'll see the applications. So from application point of view, first of all we'll see the what are the applications areas are there, and next we'll see some of the examples of the agro textiles. So let's begin with the first topic, that is the what is agro textile. What exactly is the agro textile? So this is we'll start with the symbol. This is the symbol what we are using and standard level to represent the agro textile. So we will see this diagram, or you can see the background diagram. What you will see, what do you think what it is? You might have seen this this IT form, because nowadays using a lot of places it is using. So what exactly it is? So it is nothing but we are having the combination of textile at the top side and the agriculture, what it is protecting the agriculture from using this textile. So the combination of this textile plus agriculture is nothing but a agro textile. So if you see the background image also, so in background what we are having, the form we are having, and over it is covered with the protecting cover of the textile. So that is giving the protection. So the protection, it may be from sun, it may be from wind, or it may be from many things. So the textile which we are using in agriculture is nothing but the agro textile. Now the technical textile is used for agriculture application as we have defined. So that is called as the agro textile. And the word agro textile, it can be used to classify the based on the what type of fabric we are using at what place. Like it may be a knitted agro textile product, it may be a non-woven agro product. So that type it can be used. And now based on the application, if you will see what exactly is the agro textile. So all the textile goods that intended to use in agrarian production. So agrarian production means we are using in helping the or to using the new technology in to increase the production of agriculture. So and horticulture, animal husbandry, all together it will combine together give the agro textile. So next we'll see the what is the need of agro textiles. Why we need agro textile? Can we do the farming without any agro textile? So why exactly it is needed? So as we know, there's a day by day there's an increasing population, and the pressure of that population leads to the agri farm that should give the more production to satisfy the demand of the increased population. So how we can do this thing is the agro textile is one of the way which can help to increase the production, increase the quality and other aspect. So this is the one of the measure we can use to increase the production of farm. And the next thing is that the same continuously there are the limited resources such as the land, water, energy. So therefore we have to produce the product with the with the utilization of less resources. And the third one is that the living standards increase and people want good quality of food. And not only that, good quality of food, the people nowadays, you can see the all season you will find the fruits. So how it will come? So it will come by providing a better environment to the plants, to the flowers, and to get the desired product. And this environment is provided by our agrotextile. So that is how the need of agrotextile. So the need of agrotextile is, we can summarize in such a way that first of all, to increase the production, or to help in increasing the production, and to provide the quality of food, and to give the better environment for the better flourishment of our product, that it may be food or it may be fruit. So that is the need of agrotextile. The next topic we'll see. Till now these two topics we have covered. The first we have seen what is agrotextile. The second we have seen what is the need of agrotextile. Now we'll see what are the technical aspects are there. So what are the functions of agrotextiles? What are the properties of agrotextile? And what material we are using? That we'll see now onward. Okay. So now let's begin with the topic. What is the functions of the agrotextile? So the function of agrotextile is, first thing is to protect the plant from the sunlight or UV rays. So you might know that if you keep the plant for longer time in sun, specific plant, it may damage the plant. It may not only the damaging the plant, it will evaporate whatever the water available, and it will lead to dryness, and you will get less production, and you won't get proper your farming. So this is the one of the function of the agrotextile, to give the protection from the sunlight. Similarly, the next function is that to give the protection from the hailstorm, high velocity wind. So whatever the environmental factors are there, so that protection is given by the agrotextile. It may be sunlight, it may be a wind, it may be hailstorm, it may be a fog. And the third point is that to protect it from the fog or air moisture. So all these three points are the environmental factors. So the agrotextile we are using to give the protection from these environmental factors. And also it can be used to protect the farm or foods or fruits from the birds, or whatever the damages is occurring to the fruit when it is fall. So that protection also is given by the agrotextile. So and that function we want in agrotextile. Then the another function is that to prevent the weed growth. Weed means the unwanted plant that growing in the farm, that production, the protection from that also it will give. So how it is giving the protection from the weed, that we'll see in coming PPTs. And also, especially in the horticulture, it will also act as a water transporting media. It will transport the water also. So these are the functions of agrotextile. Next, what are the properties of agrotextiles? So what properties we want? So as we have seen the function, in function we have seen it is the function should be give the protection from the sunlight, UV light, the coming airs. Now the similarly, so the same property we expect in our agrotextile. So the property is that first of all it should have the resistance to the solar radiation. It should not degrade with a continuous exposure with the sunlight. That is the first property it should have. Then next, it should have the resistance to ultraviolet radiations, and it should have the biodegradability. If you are conscious about the environment, or if you are conscious about the permeability or the fertility of your soil, then this is the point important, the biodegradability of the agrotextile. Then the high potential to retain the water in order to get a good quality of product and more production. This property we want. The property is high potential to retain the water. And also we want weather resistance. as we know, especially in the farm, this whatever the product we are using, agrotextile, it will be over the farm or under the farm or at the farm. So what we want at the farm, what happen? The weather is changing, the climate is changing. So it should have the protection against this weather resistance. And the other basic property also it should have, like basically the what tensile strength and abrasion strength, that property it should have. So that properties we expect from the agrotextile. So what we expect? So first of all, to withstand the solar radiation with the varying surrounding temperature. With respect to the deviation in temperature, it should give the resistance to the solar radiation. Next, whatever the ultraviolet radiations are coming, with respect to that also, it should give resistance as well as it should absorb the coming radiations. So some of the finishes we are using in order to absorb that radiations. And the third function is the biodegradability. So it should have the biodegradability and high potential to retain the water to prevent the soil from the drying out. Okay, that is also one of the expect. So if you retain the water, it can keep the soil moist. And weather resistance, so to protect it from the climate changes and its effect. And other basic properties: tensile strength, abrasion resistance, lightweight, and antimicrobial. So these are the properties are there for the measurement of agrotextiles. And for this property, for each property, we are having the different measuring instrument also. Okay. So in our subject, we are not going into deep. Just for information, I am telling. So this UV radiation protection, the what extent it will at what exposure it will sustain the that coming radiation, how much there will be a loss in strength, that can be measured. Each and every parameter is can be quantified. The biodegradability we can measure by keeping under the soil, how much days it will take to degrade, and next is the water retention potential, the capillary flow, the transport capillary flow, the vertical capillary flow, that whatever is studied in technical textile. So that type of testing we can do to quantify this property, high potential to retain the water. Then weather resistance. So for weather resistance, recently one instrument is came, that is called as weatherometer. So in weatherometer we can change the all the condition, temperature, pressure, and we can see the effect of that change, and we can measure, we can evaluate the function of our agrotextile. Another property, the basic property of textiles are their tensile strength, abrasion strength, that we can easily measure by with the normal instrument only. So, and also one more property is there, we have not highlighted here. You can see the one more important property is the antimicrobial property. So whatever the agrotextile is there, especially the mulch mat, we are going to keep it under the soil. So under the soil, lot of bacteria are there. So what is the effect of that bacteria onto the agrotextile, that also we have to check. If suppose if you use a cotton model oven, the bacteria will develop and it will consume with the very less time. So we cannot use the cotton. So likewise, this property also it should be important. We have to use a product, or we have to use a product with such a finish that it is giving the antimicrobial properties. So these are the properties of our agrotextiles. Now next we'll see the material details for agrotextiles. So if you are talking about the material, so in textile, what are the materials are there? Material means the fiber and the fabric. The fiber and the fabric. So the fibers that we are going to use, and what are the fabric we are going to use, that we'll see in this subtopic. So the fiber, we may have the synthetic fiber, polyester we can use, the polypropylene you can use, the nylon you can use. So out of this available synthetic fiber, the polypropylene is the first choice because of its lightweight, low cost, and also we can apply the desired finishes very easily. And also if you keep under the soil, it is having the more resistance to acid and alkali as compared to other synthetic fibers. So this is the first choice in agriculture, is the polypropylene fiber. That is the first fiber choice. Then polyester, we know the polyester is known for its customization and low cost, easily availability. So polyester also we can use. And the nylon also we can use. So nylon we are preferring to use in the construction of nets. So whatever the nets we are making, there we can use it. So because it is having the more impact resistance. Then natural fiber, we can use the jute, coir, flax, whatever the fibers are there that we are extracting from the bast or stem of plant, that only we are using. This jute fiber or coir fiber, they are very much stiff and it's having good strength, so that we are not using in apparel. But in agrotextile, it's having the more scope, especially if you want biodegradable, eco-friendly product. So there are these natural product and that natural fibers are playing very important role, and there the fiber we are going to use mainly the bast fibers. Then coming to the fabric, we may use the woven fabric, we may use the non-woven fabric, we may use the knitted fabric. So in woven fabric, so generally in woven fabric, if you want to have a long bit, because the form, the area is form is very large, so we have to make the fabric also with the a wider width. So for that we have to use the projectile loom. With the, it can give the width up to 540 cm or 846 cm. Very long width it can give. So the mainly projectile loom we are using in the construction of agro textile fabrics. Then if you are talking about the knitted, the warp knitting mainly we are using. Warp knitting we can make the different constructions and different types of combinations of yarn you can use, and with more production and with good stability, stable structure we can get. And non-woven, the mainly needle punch and spun bonded we are using, because this product are having the good property with respect to the water transmeability. So especially if you talk about a needle punch product, it can use as a water transporting media. And spun bonded fabric can be used as a barrier to the moisture and other thing. So these are the material which we are using in the agro textile. Other than this, we may have some of the finishes that we can apply over the fabric in order to get the desired property. Desired property means it may be a UV resistance. We can have for UV resistance, we are adding the UV resistance finishes. Maybe antimicrobial property. So antimicrobial property, we are adding the antimicrobial finishes, so that finishes also we may have. So these are the material detail. Now the next topic is the applications of agro textiles. So in applications of agro textile, we will see the application area. What are the area where we can use the agro textile? And what are the examples are there for the agro textile that we'll see now. So the application area. So agro textile is, it's not only concentrating on to the agriculture. Other than agriculture, it is also a product which we are using in the horticulture, which we are using in aquaculture, which we are using in animal husbandry, which we are using in forestry. So this all together, it's for forming a agro textiles. So it's very broad field, it's not limited to the agriculture. So in this further, if you see in this applications area, so in the agriculture, animal husbandry and forestry, horticulture and aquaculture, what we are having in agriculture, we are having the protection from sunlight, the coming wind, weed, the physical damage. So mainly we are concentrating onto the protection from these factors: sunlight, wind, weed and physical damage in agriculture. And in case of agriculture, we are concentrating mainly onto the protection from sunlight, the wind and the wheat which is growing unwanted plant, and the physical damage of the fruit and the products. And in animal husbandry, what we are having, whatever the product we are using for facilitating the animals. So it may be a belt for identification of the animal, it may be a path, it may be a lay for the ease movement of the animals whenever the mud is there, whenever clay is there. And in case of forestry, so mainly in forestry we are concentrating on to the protection of the soil and the weed. If you want to grow a long plant, sir, we have to control over the weed and soil also. In some places in forest you may find the soil erosion, so that also come under this forestry agrotextile product. Then in horticulture what we are having, the protection from UV lights, wind, birds and the insects. So if you see, horticulture means the flower cultivation. So in flower you will find a lot of problem with the insects and birds. So that also we may use some nets in order to protect this, and also UV protection and wind protection. And the last one is the aquaculture. So in aquaculture we may have the different nets of different walk-netted structure made for the fish, or it may be used for the anti-fouling nets, anti-fouling with proper finish that can be used. So these are the broad applications of the agrotextile. So the next topic we'll see is the what are the examples of agrotextiles are there. So if you'll see the product examples, so this is the first example, the sun screen. You can see in background, over the farm we have kept these big screens, this agrotextile. So what, for what purpose? So to give the protection from the sun rays. So it can be, it is mainly an open mesh structure, and that is constructed with somewhat more openness. And so what is the main purpose of the using this net? In order to control the sunshine, the amount of shade coming we have to control. So how does in product, we are having the different product varying from 30% to 60% shade variation, shade range. So that much percent it is the shade, that much percent of the sunlight it is allowing. Then this fabric is only restricting the sunlight, and it is easily allowing the air. So that air is important in the floriculture or in farm. So it's not restricting the movement of the air. And and also because of this open structure, if any heat is produced inside, that also will not build inside the structure. And it's available in various color, the black color, white color, the dry, the dark green color. Mostly you would have seen in many places. In many places you would have seen this. Nowadays people are using mainly this for some light protection. Then light green, green and white, blue and white. These are the all combinations it's available. Now coming to the technical, aspects of this product. So it's available in different light variation as well as different GSMs. Now see, now we'll see in the this coming video how we are measuring this shade, 30% shade or 30% or 60%. So this testing is carried out. So we'll see the testing how it is carried out. Thank you. Okay, so this video you have seen how to measure the shade percentage of the shade net. So this either it is called as sunscreen or it is called as shade net. So if you observe from 30% to 90%, the openness of this fabric is changed. 90% we are having very much open fabric, and that is allowing very less intensity of light. Now next product we'll see is a mulch mat. So in case of mulch mat, the main function is to protect the weed, to protect the farm from the weed. Weed means unwanted plant that is growing along with the target plant. So the mulch mat we can use for this purpose, and next for water transportation. So exactly what it is mulch mat. So mulch mat means, if you see this figure, what we are using here, we are using a thick layer of non-woven fabric. It may be a coir non-woven, or it may be a polypropylene non-woven, or it may be polyester needle bunch non-woven. So the thick layer we have to use, and in this layer we have to spread throughout the farm. And after putting in the farm, wherever we want our plant to grow, that place we'll keep a hole, and there we'll put our seed, and only that portion our plant will grow. And in other area the plant won't grow, because that other areas are covered by this layer of fabric, and so it restricts the sunlight at that moment, the air and other factor, so the plant not able to grow at other area. Only where holes are there, at that place only the plant is growing. So this is the two major function of this mulch mat. So in one of the study, the jute polypropylene blended needle punch non-woven has been used and for agrotextile product with a 30 to 70 GSM. And so where the jute is used to assist the water holding capacity, and polypropylene that will give the strength to the assembly. So likewise various combination you can use based on the requirement. So what we have discussed, the main criteria, main function is to protect the farm from the weed, and to give the water transportation. So other than this, what happened, this thick layer, it is avoiding the direct contact of sunlight with the water, because the water is flowing in the layer of thick layer of the fabric. So our soil is not going to be dried, it is going to be remain wet. And also because of this capillary flow, the water is going to transport throughout the farm. So throughout the farm all the plants are getting the equal quantity of water and equal quantity of nutrients. So we are getting uniform quality of the product. So this is the mulch mat functions. And example of agrotextile is the crop cover, rock cover, or anti-frost cover. So if you see the background image, so we are having the different plants or different crops are there, and that has been covered with the polypropylene spun bonded fabrics. So what is the purpose of covering these plants with these spun bonded non-woven fabric? So especially this spun bonded fabric is giving the function of the anti-frost resistance, or whatever the moisture is present in the atmosphere, or whatever the fog is there, so that won't make the droplet over the plant. So it is making one barrier in between this atmosphere and the plant, and inside it is giving the micro atmosphere that will give the flourishment of the plant. So this is especially used in the cold countries, or wherever the temperature is very low. So this the frost protection cover, it may be non-woven spun bonded or polypropylene by using polypropylene fiber, it may be knitted polypropylene or it may be polyethylene mulch mat, and it can be used at a temperature of 2 to 3 degree. So in one of the example you can see it can be used in the strawberry with a GSM of 30 GSM with 2 layer, or it can be used for the 70 GSM. It can be used for green chili, watermelon with low GSM up to 17 GSM. The next product is a agrotextile product for ground cover. If you are able to see this image properly, in between these plants we are having one pathway. So in that pathway we are using some stabilized structure, or we are using some fabric or some layer to give the stability to that area, because if there may be a rain or there may be a mud, it is creating problem. So that type of ground we can prepare using this polypropylene or other non-woven or woven fabrics. So it may be example, we can say it may be a borders or rockeries, it may be at a nurseries display area. So if you see nurseries, the lot of pots are displayed with different types of flowers. So that is displayed over some stabilized ground. So that ground we may have, and the greenhouse floor. So in greenhouse, the scientists or the people or the worker, those who are working there, frequently they have to go and they have to check the each and every plant, and so frequently they are moving. So for moving, for ease of moving, we may have, or we should have the ground cover for there. Then we for soft fruit beds, if soft fruits are there, if it is falling, so it is giving good cushion, ground plus cushioning, so that fruit also not got damaged, like tomato. Like for tomato plant, and for the orchards, the root barrier, the paved area, so at various places this ground cover we can use in horse, melange. So we'll talk about the animal husbandry, because as already I have told, it is the animal husbandry also part of agrotextile. So horse melange, so where the horse used to walk, so where they used to practice the horse, there also the full ground we may use a good cushioning type of a cover. And it can be a cycle path in between the farm, or it may be a footpath, or it may be at the golf club, golf court. So if you in golf court, if you see a lot of greenery, you will find lot of plants will find, and there obviously we need some path, so there also we can use the ground cover for using the agrotextile. So next product is the bird protection net. So the net we can use from the knitted monofilament net, the open knitted, or it may be made with the nylon yarn, multi-filament or monofilament yarn. So what is the concept of the bird protection? So we should have the open mesh net, not a finer type of net. It should be somewhat open, so that the birds cannot be entered inside. And the other the useful insect like butterfly, that the animals or the bees that are doing the pollination, that can be entered, but birds cannot be entered. So according to that, somewhat big size of the net we are making, and we are covering over the whole the plant. So especially the birds are coming for the fruits, so this bird protection net we are using for the covering of the fruits. So and also it is giving we are making it such a way that it is giving the excellent air circulation with minimum shedding. Then wind shield. So some of the plants they are dedicates, if especially if heavy wind will come, so with the velocity of wind the fruit may get fall, or it may damage the crop. For that case we may have the fruit, we may have the some shield, a wind shield, some barrier where we can use some of the opaque or some of the compact fabrics. So you can see at the background these black color is nothing but the compact fabric. where it is giving the resistance to the high velocity air. So what it is doing, it is reduce the velocity of the wind, and also that it is protect the fruit plantation, and also it prevent the plant being cooled by wind. So in cool countries there is a problem of the cold waves. So that time it will give the proper black color or insulating layer. If you use it, is also will give the insulation property, and it will protect the plant being cooled by the wind. Then the other examples are the packing materials that we use agrotextile. So nowadays you can see the onion bags. Initially it used to come in the jute bags, but now you can see the orange color or red color bags are coming open mesh. That is a Reichel knitted open fabric is there. So that is the one example I am telling. Similarly, the strawberry cover or fruits cover, we can use this type of fabric. So the advantage of using the fabric is that it is giving the protection from the outer insect and outer atmosphere. Also, it is allowing the air to come, so we can keep the food for longer time. And one other example is the root ball net. So if you want to transport the plant from one place to the another place, you can while transporting the root may get damaged. So you can cover with some special type of net. And the other product is the anti hailstone net. So if there is a hailstone is there, for that they specially will design a net with a lino cube. That is having the very firmness in the structure, and it's own allowing the size of net to be changed, and it is giving the protection from a high velocity of this hailstone. So likewise, nowadays various products are coming with a combination of textile and agriculture, and that is helpful in giving the more production to the agri textile. So till now, today's topic we have seen first of all what is the agrotextile. So the agrotextile we have defined is nothing but a combination of textile and agriculture. After we have seen the technical aspects, what are the properties are there, what are the functions are there agrotextile, and what types of material we are using. So the property and function wise, so mainly we can say that the function is to give the protection from the environmental factor. It may be sunlight, it may be the high wind, it may be a frost, it may be a fog, it may be a birds. Next, the material point of view, we are using the synthetic fiber, polypropylene mainly if you want chemical resistance, and we may go with the natural fiber if you want a biodegradability. And fabric wise, we are using a knitted fabric whenever we are making the nets. And for longer width fabric, we may go with the woven fabric also. And non-woven fabric, mainly we are using under the soil or for the cushioning. Means it may be under the mulch mat, or it may be for the cushioning, or it may be for the ground cover. And afterward, we have seen the different examples of the agrotextile. We have seen the example, the shade net. So the function of shade net is it is controlling the amount of sunlight, and it is giving the required amount of sunlight. So it is varying from 30% to 90% shade it can give. That is the first product we have seen. Then after we have seen the mulch mat. So mulch mat is nothing but the one of the fibrous layer that is transporting the water for the targeted plant, and it won't allow the other plants to grow. That we have seen. Then different types of nets are there, the butt protecting net, the wind shield, and the hailstorm net. So like that, these are the different types of agrotextile products are there. Now I will give some more information about these. So this agrotextile in India, it is making its way day by day. People are using this product. So if you all are also interested to design this product, or if you want to be more interested in seeing this or implementation of this product, so you can go with the COE of Agrotech. So Government of India has made the COE of Agrotech in Sasmira, Mumbai. You can go there. They are having the all the testing instrument, like what you have discussed, the weatherometer, the tensile strength, the flux meter for shear intensity, like all the required instrument they are having. You can go there, you can check your product. They are having the all these different needed machines and other for make the desired product. And also they are used to conduct their training program and the knowledge centers. So you may go with that and you can develop this, the idea. So that's it for the today's topic. The next topic we'll see for the another product. So the next topic will cover for the conveyor belt or transportation belt. So that's it for today's topic.